Call of Duty World War II, my goodness, I am beyond honored to say that I had the opportunity to get hands-on time with the multiplayer and record this for you guys. So today I wanted to give you my general thoughts and feelings, my first impressions of the game. I want to talk a little bit about things that have changed in the multiplayer, things that we've come to know and love that are still there, and of course, give you guys a better understanding on what to expect when the beta finally does roll around. So first things first, thank you to Activision. Without them, I wouldn't have been able to make it to E3. They provided hotel and flight accommodation for me, and of course, gave me behind-the-scenes access for World War II to record for you guys. So the burning question that's on everybody's mind, is the multiplayer good? Is it worthwhile? Is it going to be the revival of Call of Duty? In one simple answer, I can say yes. It is very, very good. It's refreshing, it changes pace just a little bit, but it doesn't stray from that Call of Duty formula. You still have that full-fledged Call of Duty game, that high-intensity, fast-paced multiplayer action that you've come to know and love in this arcade-style shooter, except you're pulled back to a different time, a more simpler time. But even with that simple time, there's still an intricate balance between creating your character customization-wise and, of course, implementing that on the field, having that variety to play however you want, whenever you want. So let's go ahead and switch our attention and talk about the new war mode. Of course, this is where the vehicles are. This is where you're going to see the tank. Other vehicles are actually score streaks, believe it or not. And some score streaks that we've come to know and love are there, like the UAV, the counter UAV. You can also see a care package in this game. Really cool stuff. There's even a plane that you can fly in and strafe over and shoot people. And then the highest streak that we got to see was a plane that you could sit in the cockpit and shoot down from above and just rain hell from above. It's really, really cool. I think that streaks are going to play a pretty crucial role in specific modes, but not war. War actually is a mode that does not feature score streaks. It's specifically set on objectives, and it really, really heavily relies on gunplay, which I absolutely love. Now, in this mode, you're either playing as an allied or an Axis force. You're going to be defending, or you're going to be pushing up. So you're going to take a house, then you're going to go and build a bridge. You actually have to build a bridge, and you're constantly fighting while this is happening. You're earning tons of XP, and of course, getting tons of kills. But at the same time, you're also going to get tons of death. And that is a huge driving factor for me, because I know that I'm not going to be dying by some random score streak or something like that. I'm going to be dying by the hands of a player who is also trying to play their objective. This is an objective player's paradise. Now, I don't know if anyone else is going to bring this up, but I definitely want to make mention of it. Divisions have a huge role in this specific mode. So here's a great example of that. I was using the airborne division with my Thompson submachine gun, and I was able to build a little bit of the bridge, but I wasn't being very successful. So I decided to switch over to the mountain division, become a sniper, and play a little more defensively. That way, my team was able to push up, build the bridge, while I slowly picked off enemies that happened to pop their heads up in the wrong places. By the way, sniping is fucking awesome. I'm just gonna say the F-bomb. It is fucking awesome, dude. Like, when you hold your breath, it actually blacks out the scope, so you still get that dual rendered scope, but then when you go into focus mode, is what they're calling it, you get that blacked out scope, and it gives you a little more focus. It really does. I like sniping this game. People might not. Quick scoping is possible, YYing is possible, but I like it. I think it's really solid as of right now. So let's go ahead and talk a little bit about this tank. The tank itself is an objective. It's not a streak, but you are able to use the MG mounted at the top. You can also be shot out of it very, very easily, so don't think you're going to be up there forever. But to be just straight up with you guys, this entire section of this war mode is a complete clusterfuck. There's so much going on. The action is constant and it's engaging, and that's what I really like. And at this particular moment, it's up for you and your team to push the tank forward to complete the objective, so you have to be within its vicinity or in the MG to move it forward, and if the enemies come and overpower you or kill you off, they can actually roll your tank back, which is crazy to say, but at the same time, it is all about the objective. Even when you're defending, you have the ability to use tools to build walls, you could build barriers to keep the enemies out, and that is awesome. You're also rewarded generously with XP when you do this, and I know that you aren't getting the score for streaks or anything, but if you're someone who loves to grind out rank, if you're someone who loves to play the objective, then this mode is definitely for you. Now, the one thing that I didn't necessarily like about it was the amount of grenade spam. am, and this could partly be due to the way the classes are set up at E3, or the divisions, rather, are set up at E3. The divisions were pre-made. We couldn't customize them, unfortunately, so some had more attachments on their weapons, some had different types of grenades, like there were smoke grenades, there were just standard Stalingrad, but there was a lot of grenade spam, from gas, to smoke, to actual explosives, and tank grenades, you know, things like that. They're just all over the place. Now, there are little, I don't want to necessarily call them perks, but perks to the division that would let you, like, protect yourself from explosives and things like that, but for the most part, I would say it was a little over the top, and that kind of brings me into the next subject, and that is deaths. I honestly feel like this mode should be a celebration of objective players, and Sledgehammer should continue to keep this mode disabled for kill death. And I know that people won't necessarily agree with that, but hear me out just for a second. In this mode, like, let's just say you decided you want to play war one day. You have the potential of getting 50, 60, 70 deaths, and it could be from random grenades, or maybe you're trying to build the bridge, or maybe you're trying to do this, or maybe you're trying to do that, and you can get a lot of deaths that would immediately ruin your kill-death ratio by playing other regular modes like team deathmatch, domination, etc. And if you decided with your 5.0 KD to go in and play war one day, and for some reason you just have an entirely MLG team on the other side just completely wiping you out, then your KD is going to be fucked. It's going to be ruined. I feel like this specific mode should be a celebration of objective, not focused on killing or deaths or anything like that. Literally go in, play the objective to your heart's content, and not worry about your actual KD ratio being ruined because you're scared to die or you're scared to go play the objective. You know what I'm saying? So I think it would be in the best interest if this was just disabled for this specific mode. Let me know what you guys think in the comment section below. Just to reiterate, War is not the only multiplayer mode in this game. Team Deathmatch exists, Domination, I'm sure Search and Destroy will be there, especially since we had the ability to set and defuse a bomb in this mode. I just wanted to focus today's gameplay play on this and kind of give you my thoughts about what I played and what I saw. Couple other things I want to confirm and deny. There is no sliding. Dolphin diving is actually back, and it's a lot more fluid. Like, I feel like you're able to jump and dive and then get up a lot faster than you could before, which is nice. The other thing that I would like to say is weapon inspects are back. Weapon inspects from Modern Warfare Remastered, one of the coolest features I thought that they added to that game, that's actually in this, and you can do it with every single weapon, which is really, really cool. But with a sigh of release and, of course, even a little bit of love, oh boy, this is a really solid Call of Duty game. I don't think we have anything to fear. I think the one thing that could really mess things up at this point is just an overabundance of customization in a supply drop system or something like that. We already know that customization is going to be possible. In fact, while I was recording this commentary, this new pre-order was announced, and you can see that these characters have different customization going on in their divisions. So I'm sure a supply drop system is going to exist. If it doesn't, then I don't know, maybe we'll find out soon. But anyway, guys, thank you so much for watching today's video. I hope you enjoyed. If you did, click the like button down below. Don't forget to subscribe for more videos coming each and every day. I'll have some more Call of Duty in the next couple of days, so stay tuned for that. And once again, guys, thank you so much for all the continued support. Big thank you to Activision for allowing me to record this for you, and I'll see you on the next one. Peace.